I should note, I don't have a full idea of what I'm doing here. That is the theme of this week. If in doubt, use tacky glue.
And there's still a whole lot of things that can go wrong.
This is just so iconically her. Like, I'm just... With this, I feel like Toph.
G'day and welcome to part 6 of Making Toph by Sunset Dragon. If you haven't seen parts 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, do check those out before you start watching this video. But in this video, we are going to cover off the wig and the headpiece. Count how many times I say, trust the process, and also complain about wigs. Enjoy!
It is time to start the final section of Toph, and that is the wig. So, before I even get out the kind of wig base that I'll be like working on, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start very mildly tonight because I have been working all day on the armor and finishing that off. I am going to start the sculpting of the back, the bun. So I've got this wonderful dinner plate that is about the right size. And I'm going to trace it onto this foam and then cut it out so I've got a bit of a round circle. I'm not going to shape it tonight or anything like that. I just want to get it started so at least I can say that I've started the wig. So let's start.
So now we have this round thing. The next thing I need to do is I need to start shaping that. But I'm going to do that on another day because I'm tired. But at least I started, right?
It is currently Friday night. It is about just past 8 p.m. I've got about another 45 minutes, an hour, until I have to pick up Terry, because he's got an event on tonight. So I thought, while I'm just waiting here, let's shape this a bit more. So the next thing I'm going to do is I've got the scissors, that Terry bought when he was making Skitty, which is purely to cut this type of foam. So these are not any scissors that are designed to cut fabric, just saying. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut around the rim just to give it more of a dome shape. I'm not going to do like a full kind of like trying to make it into like a really defined circle because I want it to be flat. Basically in like the center on both sides, I want it to be flat and I just want to kind of curve out the edges a bit. So I'm gonna roughly shape that with the scissors first and then depending on how I'm feeling and what time it is, then I'm gonna go in with the scraper and then essentially shave this off so that it becomes more of a like uniform shape. So that's the plan. If I don't get to this tonight, then so be it. I will literally get to it tomorrow because I am working on this all again. So yeah, also shout out to Animaniacs. When we were first starting Vileplume and then Skitty, so Vileplume really was our first kind of like plushy sort of mascot-esque sort of thing that we were doing. We went to Animaniacs for some advice and they gave us a treasure trove of just information of how best to shape this type of foam. Because it's one thing when you're dealing with EVA foam, it's a completely different skill working with upholstery foam. So shout out to Animaniacs, Kirilly and Scott, you guys are just the absolute bomb. Thank you so much for imparting your wisdom. And teaching me how to do this, or rather teaching Terry and then Terry teaching me. So thank you so much. I also don't know if I have explained this. I don't think I have. So the reason why I'm creating this as a base for the bun is because this is so much lighter than having essentially, you know, an entire wig. Even if you tease up a wig, it's, you know, it's going to be quite heavy to get the volume that I need. Plus also this is still squishy, but it's dense and it will allow for the hair to stick to it. It also means that it will be a lot cheaper because if I was to do it all out of hair, number one, it would be unruly, but also I can't control it as much as I would like. Whereas if there's a foam base to it, it means that I can stick hair to it and it's not gonna move.
Okay.
I think that's looking pretty good, to be honest. Because I think that the next kind of lot will be about the shaving. So I think that that's looking... Yeah, that's not looking too bad, I don't think. I still need to, once I shave it down, what I will do then is I'll figure out where it's going to sit on my head and then cut out a section of that. So it'll probably be like a section around here, which my head will fit into. And that will be sewn to the wig. So, all right, I'm gonna change my top because the shaving is gonna get very messy. All right, crafting jacket acquired. I've now put on a glove, safety first, because when you're moving quickly with this, it's very easy to scrape your hand and it's very painful. It is a like mini cheese grater. Oh, my shoulder's already sore. Okay. This is a workout. Let me show you what I've got so far because I think I'm gonna turn off the camera and do this off camera, because it's gonna take a while and I think I'm gonna need some breaks because my arm is already sore. How pathetic is that? So up here, I have shaved it and you can see it's already really quite smooth. I probably will need to go over it again as compared to like the back, it's all like jagged and stuff. So really quite smooth and I'm just gonna do that all the way around so that way I get a nice kind of even dome. And yeah, I'll probably do one pass tonight and have a look at it tomorrow in the morning and probably do a second pass. And yeah, I will check back in with you once this cheese wheel becomes a nice smooth kind of bunnish shape. Good morning, it's the next day and I've done the second pass over with the grater. And so this is what it looks like. It's relatively smooth, I'm pretty happy with it. But I've also on the inside cut out a hole and that's to essentially fit on my head. So I've done it towards the bottom. So the top is still quite the same sort of shape. And then I've cut it quite deep right at the base, which is where it fits against the, essentially the base of the wig. And then I've kind of smoothed it out. So that's what it is going to look like. And I've decided to wear it so that it is quite kind of sticking up rather than falling forward or falling back. And that's based on the reference image. So a lot of her photos of her as a character and also other cosplayers when they're doing the straight kind of canon have the kind of the bun almost detached, which is absolutely fine and looks great. But this one needs to be like, it needs to be very regal, a little bit more like when she is first introduced as like the lady. She has a little bit more, you know, controlled bun, I suppose. But yes, I think I'm going to stop shaving into this here. And the next step is to spray paint it black. We're outside again and I have my airbrushing kit out because I'm going to spray this all black just so that I've got a lovely kind of base for me then to put the hair wefts on top. So I've just turned on, I have my airbrush, I've only used this once before, but hopefully because this is all black, should be all fine. It's black. So I'm gonna let this dry, I'm gonna empty out my spray gun airbrush, I don't know why I keep calling it spray gun. And then I'll wait for it to dry, flip it over, do the other side, and then it will be all prepped to go.
It's all sprayed and it kind of looks like a burnt loaf of bread because I've got it on this, you know, cooling rack.
It's time to actually start working on the wig now. So I've got the base already done and I am now concerned that I've not cut enough away from the back, but I'll make it work. I'll make it work. So I think the next step is to prep the wig. So I have got this one wig, which is a straight black ponytail wig from Epic Cosplay. I won a voucher from them when I won Anime Los Angeles for $100 US. And so I made an order to their website and they were very kind and shipped it over to me. And yeah, so I've got this one wig. Caught onto my glasses. And then I've got four lots of extensions, two long and two short. And two of them, so one of the shorts and one of the longs, this is a short, is actually in this, I think it's called jade green or forest green. It's basically a green that has black wefts through it. And the reason why I got some of these rather than just all black wefts is because of the fact that in the reference image that I'm using, it seemed to have like a little bit of a green sheen to it. So I wanted to put some green that already has a whole lot of black through it into the wig and then into the bun. So just to kind of give it a little bit more depth, it's going to be mostly black, but I just wanted to have a little bit of a touch of green just so that it looks more like the reference image and just kind of will kind of go a bit better with the rest of the outfit, because I think if it's just black, it's gonna look very flat. So the first thing that I need to do with the wig is obviously take it out of all of its wrapping, cut off the tags, and then I'm actually going to sew in between 4 and 6 toupee clips to the, so 2 on the side, 2 at the back, and then possibly 2 on the top. I probably still will do the 2 on the top as well, just so that this is going to be very secure. From previous experiences, when I've done updos, like my Amethyst cosplay by Sakizu, you need to have the toupee clips in the wig all over, so it's very, very secure. And I find that this is the best way for me because I suffer from migraines and headaches. So when I try and put, like, you know, the bands on, it's not pretty. I already struggle with wigs most of the time, creating them and then wearing them. So I just want to make it as like easy as possible for me to wear. I also did it for my Flora cosplay as well, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, because it was also an updo, and that had lots of clips around it as well. Funnily enough, I will be using a lot of the skills that I did for Flora in this particular wig, because it's all going to be, like, except for the fringe, just like Flora, it's going to be kind of sleeked back, and then extra stubs are going to be cut off. And then from there, what will happen is that they'll be glued. But before I do all of that, what I need to do is I need to sew in the toupee clips. Then I'm going to go ahead and remove some of the wefts down near where I know that the hair is going to be coming to. I just don't need those wefts there and I'd rather use it in the bun. And then I will be adding some of the green wefts into some of the side sections just to kind of lift that, and I'll have a look and see if I can add any to the fringe. We shall see. So this is the wig just as it is straight out of the bag. And yeah, she is tight. I mean, I have a big head in every way, but yeah, she's tight. So I did notice that they've got little combs in the sides, which I quite like. I'll see, I might actually need to put the toupee clips still on the sides, but like slightly further down, I think. Because clips are good, like they're good, especially when they're already installed in the wig. But I definitely need to put 2 up here, and I definitely need to put 2 in the back as well, because I can feel this sliding up and this sliding up. So yeah, it's just, and it's honestly just because, especially for a female, I have a very like
large head. I'm glad I don't have thick hair, otherwise like literally no wigs would fit on my head. But yes, so okay, let's get the two play clips in. And yeah, I mean the sides are actually feeling quite nice. But yeah, I think I still may need the toupee clips here. So here is the wig. I've got the toupee clips already sewn in, and I didn't film that because my battery was dying, and also I'm pretty sure that I've shown you how to do that before. I think maybe in a tutorial. If I have, I'll, you know, put a link or whatnot. But yes, here she is. She didn't fit on my canvas head, which is a little bit worrying, but she has been able to fit onto my like backup one. So what I'm going to do now is take out her ponytail, see what's going on there, because it looks like this is like an extension piece, which would be really good because that means I've got more black wefts that I can work with. And I'm just going to see how it's all sitting so that I can know, okay, well, I'm going to take a weft from here, or, you know, I'm going to add green here, that sort of thing. So let's see what's underneath. Well, that didn't take long. Yes, so that is one hairpiece. That is a clip-in with a tie. It's got some good wefts there, so that will definitely be used in the bun. And then what we have left is just this short ponytail. And I know that there's so many wefts in this wig, so I'm going to undo this and have a bit of a look and see where I'm going to have the bun kind of sitting. It's pretty much going to be more down here, and so I think that I'll be taking out the wefts from around here and maybe a few through here, and maybe put some green wefts through here. Not so worried about underneath because we're not really going to be seeing that, but maybe like one or two rows of green wefts through here. So it will just have a little bit of green coming through. I think I can also get a weft or two into the fringe because I can see that it's still wefts there. They're just very, very close. So I should be able to get a weft in there as well. Anyway, let's cut that and keep on going. Sorry, I'm not filming this. It's just this wigs stress me out. So I'm just going to keep updating you with how I am progressing. She's looking a little bald at the back. So I've gone ahead and I've removed all the wefts that are kind of in the back of the hair, just because there's already so much hair here that I think I'm going to be able to cover it, no issue. I'm going to add a few green wefts, but I think what I'm going to do first is I'm actually going to tie up the kind of base layers into some little hair ties over here, just to keep it out of the way, and it's less hair that I have to deal with before I go ahead and sew the green up the top. So I've sewn in a little bit of the green weft in the fringe. It's not very noticeable just now, but I think when I style it, it will come out a little bit more clearer. And I've put it through the back here, and there's just little bits where you can see the green poking through. Which is fine. This is exactly what I wanted. I just wanted tiny little highlights of green. So I've used just over half of the short green wefts. Then I've got all of these extra short black wefts, which I might be able to use. I'll straighten them and see. I need to cut those apart, and I've still got the long green wefts and the short and the long black wefts. So it's coming together. Trust the process, right? So I've got the back of the wig kind of tied back. I haven't cut any of the hair off yet just because I just don't trust myself at this point in time. I need to sleep on it. But basically here's the bun, and when I'm placing it over roughly where the joins are, this is what it looks like. So don't worry about the fringe. The fringe is going to be the last thing that I style of this wig. Yeah, I think I need to step away from it, especially before I cut the hair off in the back. But yeah, I think it will work. I think it will work. I'm really hoping it will work. I don't know. It's the next day and we are on to the wig again. So I've got my burnt loaf here and I've gone ahead and paired up and straightened the wefts that I took out from the base wig yesterday. And then I've just cut apart the ponytail wig,
also into two sets of wefts as well each, but they're kind of already sewn together. So my plan with these ones, because these are essentially the kind of wefts that I didn't know I had, or rather I knew I had, but you know, they're not my main wefts. I'm gonna use that as a base, and I'm going to essentially glue around the kind of outer rim, because that is where the hair is going to be the finest. So I'm sure that there will be a little bit of a build up here, but that's absolutely fine. We'll cover that with the long pieces in the green and the black later. So that's absolutely fine. I'm going to do the base layer first out of all these wefts. The one time that I've done something similar to this before, wefts go very quickly. You look like you've got a lot, and then before you know it, you're out. So I've started putting the wefts onto the bun base, and I'm just gonna stop. I've put about 8 like wefts on. I'm just not sure. I'm gonna let this stay for overnight. Let all of this glue dry to make sure it actually glues, dries clear. I'm really starting to worry, and I think I might look at plan B and C and D and figure out what they are.
It's a couple of days later and I'm battling a bit of a cold, which is very frustrating because I just want to get this wig done, and my voice is pretty shot. And look, I've got this thing. It's gross. Anyway, I wanted to show you how things are progressing with the bun. Ta-da! So she's really messy. This is the first layer of hair that I've put all over the bun kind of base, just to kind of give it that hair texture. And this is wefts that I have used, taken out of the wig. So I've not even touched my extensions yet, which is what I will be doing next. But I think I need to change up my tactic because I don't really like the tacky glue. It has been good to like stick the hair kind of sort of to the base of the sponge, but like it's really hard to control. So I think I'm going to switch tactics. I'm gonna do something this afternoon and do a bit of a tester, which involves a sewing machine and creating essentially a line at the bottom of the hair, so that way it's essentially connected at the top and at the bottom so that it's nice and straight, and then I can just apply it down and sew it by hand into position. That's what I'm hoping will work. We shall see. In theory it works. I don't know, I've not seen anyone else do this that I'm aware of. So yeah, we shall see. But like, have a look. So this is the back. I'll face it towards the light so you can see. So we've got the little indentation down here, which is where the base of the wig will sit. So essentially like that. And I think it's looking, you know, it's looking like sort of what she has. It's just really messy. So I need to make sure that the next layers that go on are super smooth and they've got this nice base to go over. So at least like this layer has helped to give a little bit more of a look of hair, rather than simply I'm a sponge. So I've done a tester piece and here it is here. So this is from the ponytail thing that I got rid of. Sorry, to have to just sprayed this with got to be glued, and she is sneezing. Anyway, what I've done is I have sewn the edge of it, and I've got it as straight as possible, and it's pretty good. It will actually go over quite flat, which was the main issue that I was having with the other strands. And because it's sewn on both ends, I've got a bit more control. So what I'm gonna do, because like this is just the tester piece, I've got to do all the other pieces, and I'm gonna do all of the ponytail wigs first, just to add a little bit more bulk to the wig piece itself and to smooth over that first layer a bit more. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to sew them, and then I'm going to do some tacky glue just along where the stitches are, just to kind of give it a little bit more strength, even though it doesn't really feel like it's going anywhere, which is awesome. But yeah, so how I did that was I straightened it out to the best of my ability, and then I put a created a channel of hair which I like framed with two pieces of masking tape, and I made sure that the masking tape was on both sides, so it was like encapsulating the hair to kind of give it a good base, and then I just sewed in the middle a few times over with the straight stitch, and then finally with the zigzag stitch to kind of lock it into place. So cool. All right, that works. Good times. Now just to figure out the rest of it. I'm sure that there's an easier way. I just, wigs. Wigs!
Here are the wefts from the ponytail extension. They're all two wefts except for this one. I think this one's three. I've gone ahead, straightened them out, and then I have done a few lines of sewing at the bottom, and then I did some zigzag stitch over the top, and now what I've done is I've finished off with a row of tacky glue. Just, you know, because why not? So I'm gonna let that dry, and once that dried, I will go ahead and start putting it onto the bun, and that will create the last kind of base layer before I start working on the long green and the long black. I figured out that the short black ones that I bought are not going to reach on that. So I'm a little bit frustrated, but I guess it's a good thing that I've got too much wig kind of wefts rather than not enough. But now it's a case of making sure that when I attach the wig, like the bun to the wig, that there's not too much hole out where I've taken the weft from. I don't think that there will be. I've done like a few kind of holding them up, making sure, knowing where I'm going to sew, all of that, and it looks like it's fully covered, but you just never know. And also, I mean, I took the wefts out not so much because I needed the wefts for this, but because I wanted to make there less hair for the knobs for when I'm going to be attaching that to the wig base.
Good morning, it's a brand new day, and today's Friday, I put the weekend, and then I've got Monday, and I've got today off, and I've got Monday off, and I haven't really got all that much planned for the weekend because I want to get this week done. So yesterday I went ahead and I created these strips. So these are the wefts from the wig extension, which I have then sewn and glued the edges. So today what I'm going to do is I'm going to attach them to the bun and hopefully create a very smooth texture. It worked. My idea worked. Probably wasn't my idea to begin with, but it worked. So yay. The other thing that I've been thinking very long and hard about is the green. So I have shown you me adding the green into the base wig, and I haven't yet glued anything there. And I just feel like it was the wrong choice. Even though I really like the green and I think that it works in relation to the reference image, I just think that Toph has such an iconic hairstyle, and it is, you know, black. It is meant to be black. I think that by adding green in as like little bits of highlight, it's not ringing true for the character. So even though I've got these wonderful wefts that I have, I will not be putting it into the bun. I need to go into the base wig, undo the three top ponytails that I've created, and take out the wefts from there and also along the fringe. And then I think what I'm also going to do is, just because I'm really paranoid that I have not got enough hair, I think I might have cut it slightly too high. I think I'm gonna add another weft of black or two. I don't know, I'll play around with it. Just underneath where the wefts are at the moment, and then retie the ponytails. I know, I'm making a lot of changes, and that's just because honestly, wigs are always left to the last moment for me, like the last thing to do, because this is how I feel about them, and I feel about them very strongly.
So anyway, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to attach the wefts that I have prepared to the bun and sew them in place. And so no more tacky glue. No more tacky glue except for gluing the edges. And then once I've done that, I will sew up the long strip of hair, because the short black hair wefts that I've got are too short for what I'm needing to do next. So I'm just going to take the long black weft hair. I'm going to see how much I need in terms of getting around it, and I may actually just fold it over and double it up if there's enough to go around the entire like center of it all, just to save some work for me and to make it as smooth as possible. And then I'm going to sew the base, I'm going to glue it, happy days, and we'll wait for that to dry, and I'll probably sew that in tomorrow. Hopefully that all works and it is correct. And then while I'm waiting for that to dry, I'll go ahead and remove the green wefts that I've put into the base wig already, sew in an extra weft or two of the short black wefts that I've got, and then re-tie up the little stumps. And then I will have a look and see if I want to glue it at that point in time. I probably will. I'll probably glue it today. And then while I'm still waiting for everything to dry, if I've still got time today, I think I'll start working on the headpiece, because that still needs to be done as well. So it's now the afternoon. It's time for a little bit of an update. Let me show you how we're all sitting. So here is the very long wefts of hair, which I have doubled over and stitched up the top. So it's essentially two wefts together. And these particular wefts are actually doubled over to begin with. So it's four lots of wefts basically stacked on top of each other. I did the machine stitching, and then I've gone ahead and put tacky glue over the top. This has been sitting here like this probably for the last 2 hours, and it's only in certain sections that you can see that it's starting to dry clear. This is going to take until at least tomorrow, I reckon. I'll be lucky if it gets dry enough that I'm able to flip it tonight and do the other side with tacky glue, because I realize that because there's so much hair in this, I'll need to do tacky glue on both sides just to make sure that the ends are really, really secure. And then after that is all done, then I'll go ahead and cut off the excess down here. Speaking of cutting off excess, let's have a look at the back of the wig. So here is the back of the wig base. It looks like an absolute mess, but it's fine. Trust the process. Lacey is coming to tell me that it's all fine. But essentially, I have done a whole lot of hot glue. So I retied it after I took out all the green parts of it that I had sewn in, because, you know, change of mind. And I retied it, and I actually am much happier with the parting of this. So I did the crossover method, where I took parts of like this section here. I took a bit of this section and released part of this section, and then tied that section and this together. And then when I was doing this one, I would use the little bit left over from what was in this section to this. So that way you've got a very seamless kind of parting, which means that you've got a very nice, smooth kind of covering over the top of the head. So that's why I did that. I did it in five sections again. So two at the bottom and then three on the top. And I firstly was using like little plastic rubber bands or plastic bands, and they immediately melted when I put hot glue on them. So I had to go and I had to sacrifice three of these really lovely elastics that I had. I'll have to go get some more for myself. And what I did was I hot glued all of them, and then I hot glued into the stubs of the hair after I cut them all off. It was incredibly stressful. I burnt myself so many times. And then I went ahead after it was dry enough, and I grabbed my thread and my U-shaped needle, which is a must for any kind of wig styling that you're going to do any kind of stitching in. I've not used any other type of needle, I don't think. Apparently I have. The dogs are telling me I have. I can't remember. But
essentially I used that to connect all the pieces together, so it created like a 5-point star. Happy accident. And now it's all very secure back here, or at least so I think. And then I hit it with a whole lot of Got To Be Glue hairspray, so it's very smooth over the top. And I think that this is going to be good because the bun will kind of come to about here-ish, and I'll be able to sew that down. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with how that's looking. Trust the process, trust the process. Once I have the bun on, the last thing I'll do will be styling the fringe. I just don't want to do that until I've got all the proportions correct. It's just my head is not working in that way. Hello, welcome back. It's now later in the afternoon, basically evening, and I have all the pieces that I need for my headpiece. So I've got the headband over there, which is going to be the base of it all. And then I have these three sets of beads, all in the same color, but three different sizes. I have the little crown, which is the upside down heart, which the very first thing I need to do is glue on these little glass rondelles so that there is the little green gem in the center. I am very much looking forward to doing that. And then I also have a few other things. So I've got the wings, which you would have seen in the previous video. I've painted them all up, so they look like marble. And then I have these little connectors. So not shown in the picture, but I think that my friend Bingsy was correct. We discussed this when we were in LA because I got these from the LA Fabric District back in January. She said, look, honestly, elevate it and put connectors between the beads. So these are for the big ones. So essentially between the two edges of the big bead, there'll be that one. And then there'll be a small little connector through to the medium size, which will be this one. On top of them, it sits quite nicely, and then another connector, and then a small one to go onto the small bead, and then a small one to then connect to the wings. And I think that's going to be really nice, just tying a little bit more gold into the headpiece, which is very important. And then the last thing that I need to do, which hopefully I'll get done tonight, hopefully, if I can figure out a way, is with this and this and this, I'm going to create two of the tassel, gradient, beaded tassels to the side. So this is something that I'm very proud of. I have done a lot of beading basically when I've been sitting and I have been doing other things like watching TV or talking or something like that. I have done these beads. So I've just pulled out a whole heap, and as you can see, it's the lightest down here and it goes through gradient dyed to the dark green up the top. So this was such a cool idea. We saw this in the LA Fabric District. There was like a beaded trim, and Diana, she just basically got it and she was like, hey, look at this, rolled it up. And it had this beautiful gradient effect. And she said, why don't you do that for the tassels? Rather than dyeing the tassels, why don't you do it as a beaded tassel? It will look so cool. And she was right. Of course she's right. She's Diana. She's Bingsy. She's always right. And so I said, yeah, no problem. I'll just buy some of this trim. And she was like, no. This is $55 US a meter. You're not buying that. You're making it. And so we went to another store in the LA Fabric District and basically got a few different beads in different colors, or rather shades of green. And it worked out to being about, I think for all of the beads, which I still haven't used all of them, and I've made too many of them. I think it worked out to being about $8 US. So yeah, I would say that's a win. This is something that I started working on at the very start of the project, basically just after I had done I'd started the mock-up. I started working on this. So I'm very excited to see this come together finally. Here they are, the two tassels, as per what will fit into here from what I can figure out. Yeah, I made too many. I think I've got enough for at least another two tassels there, but oh well. Cutting off like the stems was probably the scariest part, so that was not fun.
I love it when things just work. At least that is what my measurements are telling me. So here is my headband, and this fits pretty nicely. Standard headband that, you know, goes around my head. And this is a canvas block head, which is the size of my head. So I've got it the right curve, right? Up here is the crown. Then we've got the big bead, the medium bead, and the small bead size. Then we've got the wing. And then there's a medium bead here, and then there is the gold circle with the tassel. Why I'm very happy about this is because I bought the beads in LA and I guesstimated it. I did the 3D modeling as guesstimates. And I was just praying up until this point that it was all going to fit perfectly. And I had my doubts. I'm gonna be honest, I had my doubts. And yet it does.
I'm just so relieved. As long as all of this can go on there and it fits when it's going on, I will be a happy camper. So what this means is that tonight, what I'm gonna focus on is trying to get the tassels completed and then those sewn together to a medium-sized bead. And then tomorrow I'll focus on the crown and the other beads and the wings and hopefully get this sorted tomorrow. I'm feeling really confident, but not too confident, because if you get too confident, you mess up.
And there's still a whole lot of things that can go wrong.
Okay, look at them. Here they are. Aren't they so pretty? Oh my gosh. Like, so nice, so very nice.
Good morning, so it's a brand new day and everything is looking good. So we've got so much ahead of us to get done today. Let me show you.
So starting off, we have the crown fully dried with all of the like little rondelles all sorted. So that is going to be the first thing that I'm gonna glue onto the headband today. We've got the tassels done, which I'm still so happy with. Look at that, look at the colors, they're so good. And then I've gotta put all the beads together, and I'm going to do this in parts. So I'm gonna start with the crown, then I'm gonna do the beads, put those together, and then connect them to the headband. And then I'll put the wings on, and then I'll connect the tassels to the wings. So the only downside for all of this is that I'm gonna have to use super glue, which you didn't see because I didn't film it, but I used it for the magnets and it was an absolute horrible mess. So I just need to use super glue because it is quick drying and it does connect all of the different pieces like resin and 3D printing and everything like that to items, because I found that like with the magnets and 3D printing, E6000 didn't work. So super glue will work in this case. So I'm gonna have to make sure that I use it very sparingly, but enough to stick everything on. And I need to make sure that I give it just enough time for it to set, even though it is quick drying. Once that's done, I will then be moving on to the wig. So this is all dry now. It's this one piece that I can now use, and then I will cover that. And then I will connect it to the base wig.
And here is the finished look. Oh my goodness me. So I am so happy with this. I've never done something like this before, and I am really, really happy with how it's turned out. Like just the beads and everything, they're the right length. It's all gradient dyed, the wings look really cool. It's all super glued. And I had a few little issues, which is why I wasn't filming, because honestly, I would have stressed if I was filming more. But, oh my gosh, it's not going anywhere. It feels really, really good. The only thing that I found was I was doing it on my canvas head. And so I had it all stretched out. And so these little parts have come apart. Like the super glue has popped off from the crown. But that's the only part where it's kind of like broke when the headband went back into its natural shape. And it's all fine. Like, it's absolutely fine. And I think when this has the extra kind of width of the wig, it's actually going to sit back up in that location anyway. So everything's fine. I'm very happy with it. It's really pretty. I feel like a princess. All right, okay. Now I'm gonna take a little moment to breathe. I'm gonna let this fully dry because I don't think it's fully dry yet. And I will then start working on the wig. It's now the afternoon. Headpiece is away in a different room, out of sight, out of mind, all of that good stuff. But honestly, so happy with it. Anyway, I have now got to deal with this. So here is that length of hair that I've sewn and glued at the bottom. I'm gonna trim that off and then it's time to sew it in.
This is honestly like a little bit stressful, but also super exciting because this will be the last thing that I need to do.
I am of the firm belief that anyone who says they enjoy doing cosplay wigs is a liar or a sadist. Sadist? 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 You know what I mean. I have just finished sewing on, and I use the word very loosely, all of the wefts that I have been creating with the long wefts, and it was a struggle. It did not work the way that I wanted it to work, and by the time that I realized that it wasn't working the way that I needed it to work, it was already halfway done. So I couldn't just take it all off, and it was already getting tangled up. I've done the very best that I can. I will show you what that looks like once the glue has dried. That's right, glue. I have used more tacky glue because that is the theme of this week. If in doubt, use tacky glue. The front looks quite neat, which I'm happy about. The back is a hot mess. But you know what? Most of that is going to be sewn to the base wig and you're not going to see it. So just trust the process. Just trust the process. But I can't work anymore on this wig, partly because I'm frustrated as all heck. And secondly, because I need the tacky glue to dry. So I guess I'll see you tomorrow. So annoying. It's the evening now and I've just tried on my wig and a few things. This seems to be a common recurrence of this wig where I do something and then I regret it and then have to take it out. In this case, it's the toupee clips. So I am going to take out all six of the toupee clips that I put in there and also the clips that came with the wig for the sides. Why? Because I think you can still see it. The wig is very tight on my head. It's not going anywhere. Like, it's really not. It's so, so tight. But it's weird in the sense that it's like almost loose up the top. Like the front of the wig is sitting about here on me. And like I can pull it right down to my eyebrows to make it sit properly. It's very odd. I've not had a wig do this to me before. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take out the toupee clips tonight and also the little side combs. And I'm also going to cut the little like long bangs on the side, just a little bit shorter. And then maybe I will start kind of giving them some texture and some volume so that tomorrow I can shape them into the fringe. But yeah, let's take out some of the work that I worked hard to put it all in there to make it really secure. It's just catching my hair really, really, really terribly. And so I'm really worried that not so much like my hair and like yanking it out when I'm taking off the wig. It's not that. It's the fact that this is such a stylized wig that if I'm really struggling to take it off, I'm potentially going to damage the wig. Good morning, it's a brand new day. So last night I went ahead and I texturized all of the fringe and like cut it short. And you know, this is why you need to sleep on projects, because I also figured out the reason why it's so like long, like in like this section, is because I've taken out the wefts. So there's not that stable base anymore. So once I attach the bun, that should hold it together.
So the bun is sewn on now. Yeah, I can't move it. It's slightly off centered, but I don't actually mind all that much because frankly, I have glued it in place, I've sewed it in place, and it feels pretty secure. It's not actually going anywhere. However, I think I do need to re-sew in some two play clips and actually sew them in here, because although it's still very, very tight, I think some extra kind of support here will make sure that it doesn't slide off my head. Even though it's really not. Maybe I don't need to. I think I'll style the fringe first and then I'll decide what I need to do. I've attached the base and the bun together and I've just moved up like where my last stitch was and like connected a little bit further in, and this feels so much better than what I had like just a moment ago. And oh my goodness me, it looks so good. Well, I think it looks good. I mean, I definitely can see the rough spots in it, but I'm okay with it. It's fine. It's working. It's working for Toph. So now the only thing left to do is style the bangs and then she is done. Like, I don't even think that I need those two pay clips, because honestly, this now feels really secure to my head. And I'm really happy with how this is looking. All right, so just the bangs now. Don't mess it up on the final step, hey, Kiralee.
I am so excited. The wig has been styled. The bangs have been styled. It is just now drying. So I will show you the finished look tomorrow when all of it has been dried. Yay! Here she is, the finished wig and headpiece. So let's talk about the pros and the cons. So the pros are the headpiece. I adore this headpiece. I think it turned out really, really nicely and looks really like what is in the reference image, which makes me so happy. The wig is a mixture of pro and con. Like, I am very proud of this wig. I have not had much experience or luck or love for creating crazy updos with huge amounts of hair. Like, you know, it's a lot. The balancing situation of this wig is actually very good for the wig of its size. So the band, luckily, somehow, I've made it so that it is big enough and actually kind of slides onto my head as if it was like a helmet, but it's not going anywhere. It's absolutely not going anywhere, which is so good. Like, it's amazing. I may still put some clips into the wig up here just so that when I slide it on, I can clip it in. But at the moment, it's fine. And like, I've had it on for probably about 10 minutes now and it hasn't moved. So I'm really tempted to just not, because the more that you handle this wig, the more it's potentially just gonna fall apart. Saying that, I have used so much glue and so much hairspray that I'm not allowed near any sort of open flame because I will just explode. The bangs are a little shorter than the reference image. Well, actually, they're not actually shorter than the reference image. That's the thing. The reference image has very short bangs. We know Toph as having very long bangs covering her eyes and that sort of thing. And to be honest, I kind of like having the short bangs because it does mean that when I've got the contacts in, which are blockout lenses, the small amount of sight that I will have, I will have the full range of vision because I don't have anything blocking my sight lines. And honestly, after doing CL Phantom Hive and wearing an eye patch for like trying to walk around a convention, not fun. Do not like would not encourage. So, you know, I think it's still very, very cute, especially when you go to the side profile. So I've got to make sure that all my photos are like this. So you get like the full kind of big bun look, the kind of headpiece in all of its glory, and then the sides. So you can see like the individual sections that I've done. And with that, Toph is now done. She has been one of the most complicated, biggest builds that I've ever done. I don't think I reached the 400 hours that was Jennifer and Flora, but it was real close. Like, I would say it's probably in the vicinity of somewhere between 300 and 4 hours of labor time that I've spent on this cosplay. Basically, for the last 4 months, which is how long it's taken me to make this, I've just been working constantly on Toph. I mean, literally spending about 4 days a week on average, almost full days working on her per week. And then also, you know, when I'm coming home from work, and even a little bit at work because of like the beating and stuff, with my manager's permission, just saying, I've been working on her. So 4 months of solid work and it's done. I just can't believe that she's done. Like, this is amazing. Like, this was such a complicated cosplay for me. And there's no skirt. There's no skirt. It's pants. This is just so iconically her. Like, I'm just... With this, I feel like Toph. Thank you so much for joining me on this crazy adventure, which is Toph's wig in this video, and if you've been watching the entire series, Making Toph by Sunset Dragon, it's been a roller coaster of emotions. I'm very excited to share this entire outfit, so when I take photos, they'll be on my Instagram. They're probably there now. Do check them out. But with that, I'm going to sign off. Thank you. If you've made it to the end and you've watched all 6 videos, please give us one final rock power. Yes. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next one. Bye.